Hi, I'm Jim DeCola, Master Luthier for Gibson Guitars. In previous episodes, we've discussed adjustments such as stringing your guitar, adjusting your guitar's neck, cleaning and conditioning your fingerboard, and adjusting your guitar's action. Those are adjustments that deal primarily with how your guitar functions and feels. In this episode, we're going to talk about an adjustment that will have a greater impact on the actual tone of your guitar, and that's your pickup height adjustment. If you think of the pickup as the microphone of the guitar, moving the pickups closer or farther from the strings reacts in a similar fashion as speaking closer or farther away to a microphone. As you get closer into it or closer to the strings, in the case of your pickups, it will be louder and prouder and brighter sounding. The farther away, it will lose a little bit of output and be smoother and more mellow sounding. How you adjust that height is really a personal preference. We have our specs that we'll discuss, but it's really a matter of personal preference, taste, your touch, and the sound you're going for. The first detail we'll talk about regarding pickup adjustment will be the pole piece adjustments. The pole pieces are these adjustable screws on each of the humbucking pickups. They provide adjustment for each string to have a more uniform balance. You can adjust those by listening, or to rough them in, I like to balance them with a radius. If you adjust them to a radius, your strings have a 12-inch radius to match your fretboard, right? So you try to rough your pickups in to have a similar arc. There's various tools. There's, you know, radius tools you can get from guitar shop supply places that will help you match that radius. Or you can use your 6-inch rule, as we discussed, in action adjustment, so you can measure the height. Now, it doesn't have to literally be a perfect radius, because you're going to want to listen too. Because the string gauges are different, a thicker string will have more steel, which is part of that circuit. It's an electromagnetic pickup. So a bigger string will have a higher output than a thinner string. So it doesn't necessarily have to be a perfect radius, but it is helpful to kind of rough it in accordingly. So we'll start out with a flat blade screwdriver, and you have to remember that while they're adjustable, there's a certain point of diminishing return. You don't want to just arbitrarily raise everything out of the pickup, because ultimately there's a certain point where if the screws are out too far, it's not really going to provide more output. So I like to keep the outside screws flush with the top of the pickup and then gently arc the inner four poles to provide that 12-inch radius or thereabouts. So once the pickup pole pieces are adjusted, now we can adjust the overall pickup height. And we're going to find we have a greater impact on the sound with that, because the whole pickup will be moving up and down. So for that, on Gibson guitars, depending on the model, more of our historic models will use a slotted head screwdriver, and some of our newer models will use a Phillips screwdriver. In this case, we have a slotted screw for the pickup height adjustment operation. We can use a screwdriver just like we used, but I'm going to share a little tip. Here, I've taken a small jeweler screwdriver and I put some plastic shrink tubing over the end. So now it has a little collar. So now I can take that screwdriver and drop it on top of that screw head and adjust that screw, and it will hold it in place and not potentially slip off and scratch your mounting ring or, worse, the guitar. We have the tool. We're also going to use our 6-inch machinist rule that we talked about before. Now, Gibson specs on pickup height adjustment are designed to provide, you know, a happy medium for most players. So in the bridge position or lead position, the spec is 3/16 on both sides. And when we measure that, what we're going to do is press down both E strings at the highest fret. And we're going to take our ruler and we're going to measure from the top of the pole screw to the bottom of the string. So we're looking at 3/64 on both sides under both strings. When we go to the rhythm pickup, now the spec is 4/64. And we'll do the same thing. We'll hold both E strings down and we'll measure that distance from the top of that high E string pole piece to the bottom of the string. And then the low E string to the top of the low E string pole piece. Now, those were our official specs, like I said. However, everyone's different. Your touch is different. You may be a lighter player, and that'll have an impact on the output of your pickups and sound, or you may have a different string gauge. And remember, I said earlier, the bigger the string, the more steel above that pickup. So a thicker, heavier string will have more output than a thinner string. And I'm not telling everybody you have to automatically run out and buy heavy strings, because it's a balance between your feel. And sometimes a thinner string for a lot of players will have the tone they're looking for. Even though it has a little less output, it will just have the sound they're looking for. Those are just things to remember and to consider. So now you have your specs. Now here's where you can personalize it and stray away. As I said, 3/64 for the lead pickup. You can raise it ever so slightly, but you don't want to get it much closer than that. You can maybe get it 2/64 on the treble side. I'll tell you how I like to do it personally. My preference is I like to graduate it, because typically, like on historic models where you have two identical pickups, your pickup in the rhythm position will naturally have a little bit more output than your lead pickup. It wasn't until modern times, like in the mid or late 70s, that we started making calibrated pickup sets to balance the output. So the lead pickup, because it's closer to the beginning point of the string near the bridge, will have less movement. So it will naturally have slightly less output. So you want to raise it a little closer, and your thinner strings will have a little less output than your wound strings. So I like to go like this. 3/64 on the high E side of the lead pickup, 4/64, and then go to the rhythm pickup, 4/64, and then 5/64. That way they're graduated in terms of the position and going high to the low side of the string set. For me, that works. And then it depends on the actual model of the guitar. So some guitars, I may have that same basic graduated adjustment, but I may have the overall drop to 64th or raise to 64th. But that's a good starting point for me. So if you don't have a 6-inch ruler to take your adjustment measurements, I'll share another tip with you. I go back to my coins. You can use coins as thickness gauges for your pickup height adjustment. You still want to hold your strings down at the highest fret, and then you'll use a dime, which is equivalent to 3/64, a penny, which is 4/64, or a nickel, which is 5/64. So you'd use them in the same fashion, and some actually find the thickness gauge method is a little easier, because you would slide the coin between the string and the pickup. And in the case of my recommended adjustment, I would use the dime on the treble side, the penny on the bass side, penny on the treble side of the rhythm, and then I go to the nickel for the bass side of the rhythm pickup. And then another tip, with those same coins, if you want to be safe and you want to scratch your pickups potentially, wrap them in Scotch tape and leave a little bit extra on there, so it's kind of like a little handle. So now you can take that coin, hold on to the handle, and slide it under the string, and now you're not going to potentially scratch your guitar. Again, you can keep in your guitar case, and they're very handy. So I've showed you how to take these adjustments using a 6-inch ruler or the coin thickness gauges. But there's still one more valuable tool that you have to use, and that's your ears. You have to listen to those pickups. These specs will get you very close to where they need to be, but ultimately, you need to play that guitar, and how you strike those strings and how you hear it and your guitar rig will determine what you need. You may have adjusted those pickups and got them into the ballpark. Maybe one pickup is right on. Maybe the other pickup still needs a little bit more adjustment. So just play it and adjust it and listen how it responds. A good thing to know is a full rotation of one of the pickup height adjustment screws is very slightly more than 1/64 of an inch. So if you give it one full turn, listen to it, see how it responds, maybe let a chord ring out, adjust it, like I said, and then bring it back up. And you can actually hear if it's getting in that sweet spot. Here's another thing to consider too. Some players like to have their pickups adjusted unusually farther away from the strings than a lot of players. Their theory is that since high end is attenuated at a greater rate or reduced at a greater rate, the farther the pickup is from the strings, the low end predominates. So you get a very crunchy rumble on the low end, and a lot of heavy rock players really like that. It has a very dynamic response. Another thing to consider, too, is the balance between your pickups. Some players like to have their lead and rhythm pickups adjusted so they have a great balance. They just have tonal variety as they toggle from one to the other. Another train of thought is some players like to have that lead pickup intentionally adjusted hotter than that rhythm pickup. And for them, their theory is they use that lead pickup. It's kind of like the solo pickup, so it's a little louder and prouder, a little bit more output than the rhythm pickup, which has a smoother and more mellow sound, and they'll typically use that for their rhythm or their quiet passages. So your pickup height adjustment is all a matter of personal taste. It's dependent on your touch, the string gauges you're using, your amp rig, and just the sound you're going after. So there's no right or wrong. You'd be surprised at the amount of tonal variation you can get with just some simple pickup adjustments. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out the next episode of Gibson's Guide to Guitar Setup and Maintenance.